Hello everyone. So in India, there are about 130 crore people living, and from that, only 8.46 crore people are paying the tax. So this taxpayer must be having a question that how the government spends our money, and the amount spent by them is legit or not. So here comes in the role play of CAG. Hello everyone. My name is Mitch Shah, 12 Commerce English Medium, and I am going to tell you information about CAG, the Comptroller and Auditor General of India. This is the logo of CAG. Okay. So the CAG was established by Britishers, like the other departments like Railway, Post Office, etc., in which it was established in the year 1858, and in that only auditing branch is done by CAG in India. So the CAG was established by Britishers, and CAG, there are two offices of CAG. One is in India and another one in is England. So these both are performs their part in different ways. In India, CAG performs the work of only auditing, and while in England, the CAG performs the work of controlling and auditing. So you all must be having a question of what is controlling and what is auditing. So, controlling means a person who does the regulates, directs or restrains the financial accounts of the government. And auditing means a process in which the person is granted access to verify the books of accounts and check that the books of accounts are written which are correctly or not. The Comptroller and Auditor General of India is also known as Supreme Authority of India. The just like ICAI, the CAG Act was passed in the Parliament in the year 1971, and it was amended in the Constitution of India in the year 1976. Under Chapter 5 of Article 148 to 151, the CAG has the powers of CAG has been passed. So what is CAG? So CAG does the auditing work of government owned companies. So you all know that the government, the companies in which government has stake in for more than 51% are known as government companies. And so the CAG does the auditing work of them. Appointment and removal. So CAG can be appointed by the President of India only. For that, the CAG applications of CAG are filled, and he or she must go through various kinds of examination. So the CAG is appointed by the President in front of the President House. Next. Removal. The removal of CAG can be done by three ways. When both the Houses of Parliament does the majority vote of proved misbehavior or incapacity of the CAG. Or the CAG has attained the age of 65 years and the term period of CAG is 6 years. So after that, he cannot be continue his rule. And Comptroller and Auditor General of India can remove by a procedure in which the Supreme Court judge is removed. Just like the Supreme Court judge is removed, the same procedures have to be followed while removing the CAG of India. Next. So you must be having a question that what CAG is, what a person or a firm. So basically CAG is a person in which he requires some additional helpers in which to do his auditing work much easier. So this is the structure of CAG, in which the CAG is the highest authority, and to him a secretary is appointed, under which there are 9 deputy comptroller and auditor general, additional deputy comptroller and auditor general, which are also 10, and director general 2, and the director and general of ICISA, and additional chief technology officer. So As I mentioned earlier that under Chapter 5 of Article, under Chapter 5 of Article 148 to 151, the CAG is appointed. So these articles tells us about the powers and responsibilities of CAG. Under Article 148, it deals with the appointment and oath of the CAG. Under Article 149, it deals with the duties and powers of the CAG. Under Article 150, the procedure of giving the audited accounts to the president is mentioned, and under Article 151 it says that the reports of CAG of India relating to the accounts of the union shall be submitted to the president, who shall cause them to be laid before each house of parliament. Powers: the CAG is appointed by the president only. Then the salary, service conditions, leaves, absence and pension and age of retirement is deducted from the consolidated funds of India. There are three types of funds in India: consolidated funds, public accounts and contingency fund. Powers: the expenses of the administration, for example, a CAG is doing auditing of a company and he or she must require some extra expenses to be incurred. So the CAG is allowed to do such expenses from the consolidated fund of India. Next, the CAG is having full authority to scrutinize any company which is registered under the Indian Companies Act 1956 or 2013, in which if after scrutinizing them and having having a reasonable answer, then the CAG may withdraw his objection or can scrutinize them for further. So these are the list of Comptroller Auditor General of India after independence. So the first Comptroller and Auditor General of India was V. Narahari Rao, whose term was 1948 to 1951, which is 6 years. Next, the current CAG of India is Girish Chandra Murmu. He was appointed on 8 August 2020. Role of CAG. The role of CAG is that the office is responsible to and is an agent of Parliament and conducts audits of expenditure. The accountability of executive. For example, a railway minister is asking for a sum of rupees 200 crores for developing a new railroad, and what if he spends only just 150 crores? So these 50 crores are audited by the CAG, and the CBI takes the necessary actions. The CAG has to ascertain whether the money shown in the accounts as having been disbursed was legally available for and applicable to the service of purpose to which they have been applied or charged, and whether the expenditure confirms the authority and governs it. The secret service. So in India there are some secret service like defense, NIA, RNAW. So in order to not to disclose these audited accounts, the defense ministries offer the certificate, and in which the CAG has approval and go further. CAG audit. All the receipts and expenditure from the Consolidated Fund of India, Contingency Fund and public accounts. All the trading, manufacturing, P&L and balance sheet of all the companies, and all the stores and stock of the government authorities. Accounts of the central government corporation whose act provide for audit by the CAG. Accounts of authorities who are not financed by the government, but on the request of governor or the president of India, the CAG reports audits them. Auditing the receipts and expenditure of the government of India and each state to ensure that the rules and procedures in that regard are designed to secure an effective check on assessment, collection and proper allocation of revenue. CAG reports. There are three types of reports that CAG provides: audit report on appropriation account, audit report on finance account, audit report on public undertakings. The audit report on appropriation account shows the appropriation of money granted by the legislature to the various grants and heads of expenditure and whether that the money spent is for that specific purpose or not. Audit reports on finance account. These are the reports showing that the reports are for annual receipts and expenditure of the current year. And the audit report on public undertakings like railway, post, etc. Process of submission of audited accounts to state government. If the governor requests the CAG to do audit of something, then audited reports is submitted to by the CAG to the governor, and the governor can place them to the both the houses. State government. Next, process of submitting reports to the president. During the course of inspection of various organizations, inspection reports of each unit are prepared and copies are sent to them. About 72,000 inspection reports are sent in a year, in which the most important audited reports of that firm are included. Before they are presented to the president, they are rigorously checked by the CAG and countersigned by it. So, the submitting, president shall pass them to the both houses of the parliament, and after they are submitted to the legislator, the public accounts, they are submitted to public accounts committee, which includes railways, post, telegraph and other departmental undertakings, and the company's reports are sent to the committee on public undertakings, COPU. Scam. So currently the 5G scams, 5G spectrum auction are in role. So the 5G spectrum is done on basis of auction. So in the year 2007 to 2009, India was divided between 22 zones and with 281 licenses. There were total 15 suspects, and the prime suspect was A. Raja, the head of telecom minister in the year 2007 to 2009. The total loss was 1.76 crore rupees. And the major benefited companies were Swan Telecom and Unitel. So what happened in that scam, that A. Raja was accused for advancing the cutoff dates and not taking the advice of the finance ministries, law and justice, and TRAI, the Telecom Authority of India. So in which A. Raja advanced the cutoff dates from 1 January to 25th September. So he was accused for that, and after investigation of CBI, it was found that the Swan Infotech and Unitech Wireless gave him 3,000 crore rupees for advancing the cutoff rate. So the Swan Telecom was granted with license for rupees 1,537 crores, who sold just 45% stake to UAE-based company for rupees 4,200 crores, and Unitech Wireless, who obtained the license for 1,661 crores, sold its share to Telenor for rupees 6,200 crores. Thank you.